Okay. So it's okay, you know, John. You may start.
Yes.
Okay. So, good evening to everyone. You are very welcome to 13th of 2020 Fall Semester's Archidesign Talk Series tonight, organized by Bauer Faculty of Architecture and Design. And today, it's an honor for me to host two very special names who have contributed to a great impact to interior architectural education in Turkey. So I'm grateful to introduce you, Ms. Sezin Tanrıöver, who is my former schoolmate and now my department's head. And also, I'm very proud that she is a female woman, female presenter of our country in international era in IFI. And my dear Ahmet Sezgin, who is also acting as department's head of Interior Architectural Design Department in MEF University. And he also has used to be our colleague, our office mates in Bauer Architecture and Design Faculty 4 years until around 2013. Is it right, Hocam? As soon as I remember, it's like 2013, you, I mean, quit Bauer. Okay, then he engaged to MEF University Interior Architectural Department and conducted the curriculum of Interior Architectural Design Department there. And still, he is there. But these two valuable academicians continue to cooperate in many workshops, conferences, and juries, which I have also witnessed most of them. In addition to their in-curriculum studies, they have leaded the most pioneering organization for the sake of the future of interior architectural education of Turkey, which is actually the main topic of our presentation tonight. It's IM student competitions. Actually, it's IM in Turkish, iç mimarlık, but yeah, I call it as IM competitions.
Yeah, good.
Okay, so IM competitions, let's say, is started in like 2017 when Tanrıöver and Sezgin came together with Chamber of Interior Architects or Designers to give start a new competition that will be the touchstone of initiating a traditional competition among students of interior architecture in Turkey. So that's all from me. From that time, I want to leave the screen to Tanrıöver and Sezgin to tell their story, how the story continued since that time until today. The screen is yours, Hocam.
Thank you, Melat Hocam. Maybe I can start by thanking. Dear students and members of Faculty of Architecture and Design, it's a pleasure for us to share our three-year experience and thoughts in the process of establishing IM competitions or IM competitions. And it was a wonderful introduction, Melat Hocam. Thank you for your very nice words. And it's always a pleasure to collaborate with Ahmet Hocam, Ahmet Sezgin Hocam. Thanks to this event, we once more got together and remembered our journey through IM competitions. So,
thank you.
Ahmet Hocam, would you like to say a word? Do you hear us?
Yeah, I can, definitely. Okay. I would like just to add that it is really an honor and, you know, lots of pleasure to be here. I'm really excited to be among my colleagues at Bahçeşehir University. Yeah, thanks for inviting me. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, we appreciate it, Hocam. Thank you for coming, being with us.
So maybe I can proceed and start the presentation. Please. Okay. Today we're going to look at the interior architecture competitions in a comparative perspective. We will look at the history of competitions in architecture and interior architecture very briefly first, and we'll explain where the competitions in the field of interior architecture stand in comparison to the field of architecture. We'll discuss why competitions in our field in interior architecture started to appear very recently. And although these disciplines, architecture and interior architecture, they address designing spaces in various scales, international competitions, why they are in our field in interior architecture, why they are rare, and mostly awards are given, but not the competitions are being organized, and how and why we started out together to establish IM competitions or IM competitions. Finally, we will be concluding by mentioning the role of competitions in for both professionals and students. So, as I said, as a very brief timeline, we can talk about the history. So long before 20th century, way before interior architecture profession gained recognition, and so does the competitions in the field. The competitions in the field of architecture were organized even since Renaissance. So if we are very shortly, if we look at the very brief timeline, let me say, which you are seeing at the moment, we can talk about three milestones on the way, which the first one appears in the Renaissance period, the architectural competitions requesting design for a specific location and program. It started like that. So in the 18th century, where the awards for professional achievements by some institutions have been given to certain professionals like RIBA, these institutions were RIBA, AHAN, Pritzker, UIA. And lastly, we can talk about around 90s in the 20th century, besides competitions, we come across with awards, awarding systems, evaluating projects completed annually. So this is where we start seeing the adoption of award system by the field of interior architecture, or we can say slash design. So what we are now talking about is the awards evaluating projects completed annually in different areas and in different scales of design. So we are coming across with the system also in architecture, not just interior architecture. So we're going to talk about these more in the coming slides. So maybe I can say that this system being adopted by the profession of interior architecture mostly depends on its dynamic production and consumption cycle, which basically appeared in around 90s at the very end of 20th century. So Ahmet Hocam, maybe you can continue. I'll move the slide.
Yeah, thank you. I would like to do a brief, let's say, introduction or brief overview of this, one of the major types of design competitions, namely, you know, competitions asking for a design for a specific site and topic. As you, as Sezin has just mentioned, we can trace back history of these two as early as Renaissance. And a couple of features, characteristics of these, we want to underline, because we think it is important. It will be important insight giving for especially students who are watching us to understand what can be the role of these competitions in their professional career. These, on the slide, you can see two photos. One photo is the upper one is from the famous Sydney Opera House competition. The jury is, you know, checking a large pile of projects in front of them. And there is an anecdote about this, quite famous anecdote about this jury or the committee, stating that, you know, the Sarina was quite late, a bit late, couple of days or more, somehow, to the convening of the jury. But after he arrived, he immediately took notice of the one of the projects, later the winning project, and pushed it forward to be eventually to be the winner. So this anecdote is most of the time, let's say, told to underline the fact that the juries, you know, in all competitions, whether it is for a specific site or not, somehow is based on the, you know, the kind of synergy of the jury members. This is one of the quite fundamental, let's say, characteristics of the, you know, of the competitions. Sometimes we tend to, especially our young colleagues nowadays, you know, the students and maximums may tend to think that there are certain criteria for evaluation of the project submitted to the competitions. But in fact, each competition, due to the, you know, the composition of the jury members, also, you know, the entries to the competition, which project submitted to the competition, is a unique evaluation process in which also somehow also the chance may have a role, as the anecdote tries to, you know, imply. That is a important, significant fact about the competitions, that you don't have criteria. Even the, you know, the composition of the entries, projects submitted, how radical some of them are, will be quite important to for the end result, outcome of the competition. Another, based on these photos, by the way, I have talked about the upper photo, and on the lower part you have the jury of from 1980s, the upper one from 1950s, from the, as I said, jury of the Sydney Opera House competition. The lower one, the lower photo, again black and white, is from the Ahan Award. So that is another type of competition, just Sezin mentioned. You know, instead of a for a specific type and topic, you you have a large compilation of projects in the field of design, and in this case, from architecture, from the field of architecture, and they have to be evaluated. Interesting thing is here is this, for instance, in this case, Ahan Award has a mission for a particular group of countries with the, you know, it's somehow Islamic identity. It tries to promote, let's say, better, sophisticated architecture in these countries. So the from very different settings, you have these photos. But what is, you know, common of these photos is, if you have noticed, if please look at the jury members, one from the 1950s, one from the 1980s. Common point is, which, apart from one exception, all from, you know, white middle-aged men, very typical in the field of architecture, actually. So competition, you know, the field of design, especially architecture, I can say, I'm not very knowledgeable about the fields of the design in this manner, but we can fairly say that until recently, especially, quite a, you know, a male-dominated field. And the competitions, If we pass to the next slide, could you? Thank you.
Sure.
Competitions is a kind of let's say possibility, opportunity, great opportunity for young designers, in this case architects, to be able to, you know, break these prejudices present in the field. So here you you see a couple of, we have listed a couple of common characteristics for these type of competitions, namely competitions for a specific site and topic. And at the upper part you see two photos, as I assume some of you have already recognized. So these two designs are by two different very now famous female designers. One Zaha Hadid and the other is Maya Lin. On the left you will see the Zaha Hadid's competition winning entry for a complex in that in Hong Kong, that there was a competition, and that was one of the milestones in her career, you know, to put her name in the, let's say, in the field. And the second one, in the case of Maya Lin, this is the Vietnam Veterans Memorial in Washington. Very interesting story it has got, and I think that can be quite, you know, let's say, encouraging for the students who are watching us at the moment, because it shows that how a competition, in this case a competition for a specific topic and site, or it can be a effort type of, let's say, competition as well, can be a groundbreaking milestone in someone's career. How can it, as we have just written here, promise a bright future and fame for young designers? So if we pass to the next slide, I will just, in a couple of sentences, I will try to explain the importance of it. How, you know, competitions can empower young designers. This is, I think, as I said, excellent case. Why? You see the at the upper photo, you see the Maya Lin holding the model of her design for Vietnam Veterans Memorial, and this was, you know, it should be 1980. And remember, it was quite a long time after the end of the Vietnam War Memorial. This was a quite awaited project. There was a competition, and, you know, lots of people expecting something, you know, what was the image in our minds about the Vietnam War from the American perspective, let's say, you know, again, male American, probably wild male, young soldier fighting, quite macho images, and, you know, a memorial that can evoke that image. That would be, you know, lots of people's expectations. Then you have the winner entry. The winner is, you know, a Chinese-American, Maya Lin, a young, a still, that's important in my opinion, she was still a student at the Department of Architecture. And this was actually a project she was she submitted for one of her classes, because, you know, the class asked for a project as the final work, and the, I think, if I'm not mistaken, the course or class was about funeral architecture. So she submitted it. She also submitted this to the
Ahmet Hocam.
Can you
yes,
hear me?
Yes, now we can hear you.
It's okay
yes.
Now.
Okay. Yeah. So at the bottom right corner, you can see her entry. So simple, architecture student, but very strong design idea, design concept she had. We don't have time to go into detail about it, but I would suggest, especially to the students listening us here, to check this project and to check in detail this story. Very good, a very nice example showing how a competition, especially an interesting one like this, can be a very good kick, very good start for a professional career. So from there, I will give the stage to Sezin for the next slide, I would say.
Okay, thank you, Ahmet Hocam. So
my pleasure.
So I will be continuing to the presentation in a manner which I will be talking more on the interior architecture competitions, and I'm going to be now emphasizing a little bit about the differences in the field of architecture and interior architecture, and how this difference also is being reflected in the competition issue. So in a comparative perspective, we can say that architecture, the field of architecture and interior architecture, these professions, they have a very different character and paces when it comes to professional practice. So in architecture, fewer designs and constructions of especially public buildings become subjects of competitions. And nowadays, especially in Europe, mostly preserving what is existing or applying adaptive reuse, or let me say adopting adaptive reuse, is much more in the front. However, while in interior architecture, there is a very fast cycle of designing, constructing, and consumption of the space, of the interior. So this is especially appearing in the last 30 years due to the diverse global economy, which we have mentioned as the last, the 19s, as the last milestone in the very brief timeline of ours. So this is basically the reason for being so different, maybe. So we're going to be looking at some of the institutional competitions. So why we are looking at these? Because these institutions, which have been listed at the moment on the slide, the first one is IIDA, International Interior Design Association, and the other one, International Federation of Interior Architects or Designers. These two institutions especially appeared in the 90s with the competitions, by organizing institutional competitions and award systems. So these two institutions, we can say, are the pioneers, are the major institutes to start this trend of awarding the existing projects, or let me say, annually completed projects in the field of interior architecture. They both reward designs in specific categories, as now you're seeing the list of the categories. These categories may be regional, these categories may be national, international. They select the best designed, constructed, and useful, and also original products, meaning the spaces. And we see not just one category, but many categories. Even some categories have subcategories underneath themselves. So I'm saying that These institutes, they select the best design, constructed, original idea. This is something different from the competitions in the field of architecture. What we see here is the evaluation of the completed project. So the evaluation, or let me say, the competition starts after the project's completion. But in architecture, before the construction stage the design which is going to be constructed will be or is being selected by a group of jury. Of course, in interior design, it's the same. The jury decides, the jury evaluates. However, this happens after the design's completion. In architecture, it happens before, of course, the construction period. So among a lot of participants, the jury decides on the best. Best is a very hard word. I'm sorry. Maybe the useful, the original, best idea, architectural idea or proposal among the participants. So this is basically the major difference, what we are seeing in between the awards and competitions, and what we are mostly seeing in the field of interior architecture is the awarding system. So as you are seeing now the list, so I first refer to the IFI, International Federation of Interior Architects, DDA, meaning Design Distinction Awards. These are global awards given to different categories that have been listed at the moment on the slide. So these are professional categories. However, there is a category for students. So they are also expecting students to participate to these awards with their student works. And this is annually repeating. So this is a global awarding system and it's open to students. So this is a hint for you to maybe to follow up. And another awarding systems appears as IFI GAP program, which is global awards, which means that it's an award to an individual or a collective who made an outstanding international contribution to the field of interior architecture. So these are two different systems. One is a personal award. The other one is goes to the projects and within different categories. And now you're seeing some pieces from the websites of IIDA. These are just examples, but I was mentioning that these award systems, they are also being being applied according to or categorized, let me say, regional, international, national. So this is for the best designs awards for the Asia Pacific region in 2020. And it's still open. Oh, I'm sorry, it's closed at the moment. So this is honoring outstanding creativity and design in interior architecture projects based in Asia Pacific countries across 15 categories. So within this awarding system, there are 15 categories. And we're saying also in IIDA, a kind of an encouragement award, which is appearing as 2021 and Ana Hernandez Luna Textiles Visionary Award. So it's recognizing mostly women who has recently established an interior design or product design business and is making a difference in her profession. So these are quite important awards. Some of them are awarding the project, some of them are awarding the initiative of individuals. And here comes the student design competition for 2021, and it's still open. So it's open to honoring the talent and innovative thinking of interior design students. And it of course aims to showcase the emerging professionals in the interior design industry. So it's a challenge for you, but it's showcasing students to the interior design community. So these are quite important issues, I think, for you. So Ahmet Hocam, maybe you can continue.
Sure, thank you.
Thank you.
So that is actually briefly, this was our, let's say, thought process. We contemplated about all these, what we have summarized to you before venturing into the, you know, IM competitions or you know, interior design or interior architecture student competition we launched with the Chamber of Interior Architects in Turkey a couple of years ago.
You so like the name of IM, right?
Yeah.
Sorry for disturbing. No problem.
So what we had was, you know, as we have seen in the field of architecture, there are lots of cases of competitions for a specific site topic, and you have also, as Sezin just explained, an award competitions, you may call them. And so in Turkey too, of course, there was Mekan competitions, which is an IM competitions also, a kind of award competition, award system, or you may call it. There are projects, of course, because they are student projects, they are unrealized, and the jury evaluates them according to regarding certain criteria to find the most sophisticated 10 of them, 6 of them, whatever. And we drew on a lot about the experience of these past competitions as much as we could. We did research, then we launched this competition, and it began in 2018. We can move at this point to the next slide, I would say. And the up to now, the we will come also to that. I will not immediately give the numbers, but I can say that quite a promising reaction or participation from the students at the departments of interior design and architecture we receive. Quite large wide participation we had, and not from the students only, but also what was so encouraging for us was we thought that we really, you know, we did something that is respond to a large, let's say, demand. We thought after we launched this IM competition, why not only a large participation from the students, but also we have seen a large interest from our colleagues. And that is one of our, you know, what these, if we come to the question of what do these award competitions achieve, particularly for, if we want to answer this question, respond to this question, from the case of IM competitions, a couple of points we would like to underline. What is the role of these competitions in the field of interior design architecture? It really, you know, contributes to the quality of the education of education at the undergraduate level in the field of interior design and architecture. Why? Because it enables the students to see what is going on, not only at their faculty, but also other faculties. sometimes, in some cases, ones that are hundreds of kilometers away. And for that's also true for us, for the, you know, instructors, professors, assistant professors, etc. In these institutions, we have chance to talk about, otherwise we have, to be honest, not so much chance, opportunity for that, to talk about different educational approaches, because each project represents an approach, in fact. And it is a chance for us to see what our, for instance, colleagues think about our approach. And also it is an great opportunity to see, because there's such a large number of, in Turkey now we have departments of interior design and architecture, lots of diverse approaches, and it is a great opportunity to see radical, new approaches, innovative approaches, for instance. Immediately now, thanks to these competitions, we can immediately notice, talk about these. I think this is a great, you know, contribution of these to the field. And another important contribution of these competitions to the field is, of course, as I have already mentioned, it gives a unique opportunity to students as a breakthrough, you know, to put your name in the field. A great opportunity for young interior architects or designers to introduce themselves to the community.
Okay. Moving on. Sure.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. So what we see here is the posters of, you know, the three consecutive IM competitions that was, you know, organized so far. The third one will be, you know, the results of the outcomes of the third one will be announced tomorrow. The first one was at MEF University, and quite large number of entries we had there. Even more promising was, you know, the number of the entries, not only the number, also the scope of the entries at Bahçeşehir, and about that Sezin can talk.
Sure, hocam. So about the 2019 IM competitions, we were very excited, of course, as a host, but also as one of the organizers, Ahmet Hocam, me, and the Chamber of Interior Architects. For 2018 and 2019, we have collaborated very deeply, very, you know, very... in a very disciplined way, and with the outcomes we were very happy. We have seen that the participation of institutions year by year, we have seen an increase, a significant increase. The first one had 34 institutions, meaning 34 interior architecture programs in the national scope. So in the second one, we have seen 15 institutions, 15 programs, 50 programs, I'm sorry, participating. So the students from 50 programs competing with each other within five categories, first, second, third, and fourth year design studios, and also the furniture design studio. And again, we have seen a significant increase in the participating projects from 351 to 482. And of course, we're expecting to be seeing more in tomorrow, hopefully, in the colloquium, which is going to take place at 5 o'clock. And the host is Başkent University this time. So it's going to be, again, a very exciting event, most probably. I know that MEF University and BAU, we have some participants, some competitors. So we're going to see what's going on, what's who got to win, who got to actually win. Is some winning an award is yes, for sure it's important, but being a part of this organization is much more important, I think, than getting an award. It may not seem to you as so, but participating in such events, participating and following such events are very valuable contributions to your professional career, which starts very early in the student years of yours. So what we have seen, as Ahmet Hoca said, as the jury members, again, a great participation from the educators of 28 institutions last year. And we know that this year in Başkent University, there are a lot of, again, educators collaborating for as jury members, especially from Anatolian universities. So it's going to bring another kind of trend, another kind of point of view, perspective to interior architecture educational field, let me say. So maybe I can show some photographs to you from 2018. This is the event, the first event of IM competitions, which was hosted by MEF University and the representative of MEF University. By that time, again, Ahmet Hocam was leading the team of MEF University for the organization of the competition there. Very nice photographs from the jury sessions, where we aimed such outcomes like increasing communication between educators, increasing communication between students. So what we are seeing at the moment, a really fruitful discussion, let me say fruitful discussions, because there were five groups, five categories and five groups of jury members. So we were really discussing very efficiently, thinking about what to do next year, what shall we change in our programs so that our students can be more successful within these kinds of events. So all these discussions, sharing new innovative educational approaches, just like Ahmet said, and as a total, as a result, what we are aiming, all of us, was, of course, achieving a very achieving a decent, or let me say, a good level of quality in education, which can step by step, of course, develop in time with these competitions and with all of these communications. So we are trying to turn our heads towards a more qualitative approach in the interior architectural education. So this is from the jury sessions, but now you're going to see, of course, the awards. Now this time you're seeing the second IM competitions from which we have hosted as BAU last year. Some of you may remember, and I remember some of our students being participants and even award winners. So what we are now seeing is a different part of the competitions. Another outcome is to point out the talented future professionals. So this is what's happening, actually. We are pointing out our talented, innovative students, and we are actually trying to encourage you, dear students, to do better, to improve your performances while stepping out towards the professional field. So also, it's very important to internalize, to own your professions as interior architects. So being proud of yourselves, being proud of your professions, and really internalizing what you're doing is the most important thing maybe in life when dealing with your, you know, your profession. So, at the very lowest part of the photographs, another outcome, the communication expands, you know. Of course, with the colloquium, discussing professional values, educational values, teaching methods, it becomes open, it becomes public, it becomes honest, it becomes transparent. So this transparent way of discussion is, again, a very important thing in our profession. So we think that. Communication and integration of all stakeholders within these competitions is the most valuable issues, I think. So the joyful moments that we had in the cocktail and exhibition after the colloquium is the parts that you are seeing at the very lowest photographs. So maybe, Ahmet Hocam, shall we conclude? Shall I leave the microphone to you? I talk too much.
but you have, you know, you have summarized perfectly, yes, in my opinion. And some of these we have already highlighted, yes, actually, the, you, yeah, know, these...
On the way, we have talked about them, yeah.
Yeah, these competitions, how do they contribute to our field? A couple of them I want to highlight again, that these ones that maybe not underlined strongly. The competitions, the role of competitions as platforms, and this can be, if we go back to the slide before this with the photos once more. If I would like to,
which one, Hocam?
The slide just before this one, with the photos.
With the photos, okay.
Yeah.
This one.
Photos at Bahçeşehir.
Photos at Bahçeşehir. Okay, Hocam.
Yeah. And there, when you look at the you have the colloquium, and also at the lower part of the slide, we had the photos from the after the colloquium. We had a very nice, you know, let's say post-colloquium session with, of course, with a magnificent view of Bosphorus, unique to Bahçeşehir University. We were, you know, I was delighted to meet that view again after a while, and there that was a very, very, for the ones who were there would remember, I think, that was a very, very lively session. And for students, it was a great, great opportunity after the, you know, formal talks at the colloquium, which are also very important, mm-hmm, but afterwards, quite informal setting to meet with lots of professions from other universities, from other institutions. Great opportunity for the students beginning to, who wants to begin to establish, let's say, their network in the, mm-hmm, profession. So as a platform, you know, much more than, you know, picking up the first one, the second one, the third one. And as we have just said, it can be at a certain degree, of course, a random. You compile a different jury member, different composition of jury members, you can have, you will have different outcome. And when you think about, you know, what jury members evaluate, you know, one project in interior design, in interior architecture, lots of entries, meaning that one entry can be design of a hotel, the other can be hospital, but another one can be a dwelling or a just a kitchen maybe. Mm-hmm. And in fact, it is an impossible task to, you know, compare them with each other in a way. But yes. The intention is not comparing in that sense. We always saw, therefore, this as a, you know, that was our always a discussion. As we have underlined, we discussed a lot what should be the role of this competition, I Am Competition, once we launch. It should be a meeting point. It should be a platform more than anything else. And I think these photos demonstrate it very vividly, in my opinion. Yeah. So,
I totally agree, Ahmet Hocam.
And I would conclude, you know, with an invitation to all of you, especially the students, therefore, to be present at tomorrow's colloquium and always check these competitions. Each one is, let me use the metaphor, a window opening to your, you know, new professional life. And from one window, it is possible that you will see the bright sky and sun shining. Sometimes it can be cloudy and raining from that window. Not all competitions, you know, and it's not for everyone. It is impossible. But you can see the sunshine from that window. It's a great opportunity. And we are very happy that we gave one opportunity, at least, you know, I Am Competitions to the students.
Very nice conclusion, Ahmet Hocam.
Yeah.
And I would like to add just a few information about tomorrow. Please, dear students, you can find this in our social media as well, the I Am 2020 competitions, Zoom meeting IDs and passcodes. And we will be again talking there. Ahmet Hocam will be the third year representative and I'll be the second year representative, jury representatives, talking about the evaluation process of the project. So you may be interested in really understanding and looking deep down into how this process is being handled by the jury, what's going on, what's the process. So be there, follow the colloquium, try to meet your colleagues, let me say future colleagues, online. This is the situation. The only thing that we can do is to communicate online, but seeing what's going on in the field by starting from your student years, educational years, will be giving you a great opportunity for your future. So thank you, let me say, and yes, we thank you all.
Okay, thank you very much, Hocalarım. Yeah, that was a very, I think it's a very friendly and talk. And yeah, I just, I mean, went through all the history of I Am competitions because I had the kind of luck to be a small part of it. In the previous I Am competitions, like I was honored to be one of the colloquium speaker in the first one. Thank you for that again to Ahmet Hoca. And yeah, I experienced all these confrontations, encountering together and sharing ideas. And yeah, I again want to thank to you, Ahmet Hocam, in the beginning, talking about this encouraging and thought-provoking ideas, like, I mean, and looking from a different side, kind of stressing on female gender encouraging point. Thank you for that. And thank you for your, again, encouraging concluding words, metaphorically. Thank you. And Sezin Hocam, again, thank you very much for this opening mind, let's say, words, like, I mean, informative words, because I'm not very sure that our students are very much aware of the international competitions. we strongly need to repeat and repeat these informations, and it's very important to hear from your side, I mean, from you. And I just want to repeat the announcements that this year's colloquium will be tomorrow. And what's the time, the hour, the period? Maybe we can repeat it.
Yeah, let me share once more.
Yeah.
So even I may just enlarge it. Tomorrow, tomorrow it's going to be on this Zoom meeting link. Let me, yes, you can now see the Zoom ID and the passcode. And it's going to start at 5 o'clock. And it's going to start with the awards. Then the awards will be followed by the colloquium, the discussions about the projects.
Yeah. Yeah, that's really important. Okay, maybe we can leave the sound to voice to students and our faculty members or our guests if they have any question to forward to you. Firstly, you can write to the chat box, or you can just raise your hand, or just open your microphone and ask questions. Is there anyone who want to forward any question or any contribution? Ümit Hocam, yeah?
Yes. First, thanks to Sezen Hoca and Ahmet Hoca. I want to make a small contribution. It is related with my age. Ahmet Hoca, on the beginning of competitions, interior design competitions in Turkey, said that there is no any institutional professional competition yet. I remember.
About interior design, you mean?
Interior design. There is no any interior design competition yet in Turkey. But I remember one, but only one.
Mekan mı hocam?
No, mekan değil.
Okay.
So this was the reuse of the Turkish Parliament main meeting hall. It is only
yes, I remember that
only
too, hocam.
Interior design competition that I know in my professional life.
Yes, yes.
Ministry of Public Works opened hundreds of Turkish hundreds of architectural design, but only one interior design competition. I think the existing chamber and existing hall is the product of this competition.
Yes, hocam, you're right. I remember that competition. It was around the end of 90s, if I'm not mistaken.
I think it's in 60s.
Oh,
60s? 60s? No,
or 80s.
And again, in 90s, there was 70s another competition.
At the last years of 70s or on the beginning of 18s.
Hocam, if it's that time, we cannot remember. Sezin Hoca and I cannot remember, but I remember.
I remember one afterwards, in the at the very end of 90s, hocam, I remember myself graduated very, I mean, newly graduated, and remember that competition.
And the first one at that time.
Yes. But only, I don't know another one.
Yeah. Thank you for this contribution.
Thanks a lot for the contribution. Quick note, I think it is due to the a bit awkward wording there. We try to mean that there is no ongoing, continuous tradition of interior design competitions, like annually, each year, again and again. There is nothing such yet. But very recently, Chamber of Interior Architects They are working on it. They are planning to, they are planning to begin to organize one, institutional, each year, annually, hours given. So that's promising news for us.
Thank you. Thank you very much for the contribution and answer. And is there any other contribution? Any word? Any hello? Maybe we can some open the way. I mean, I have some words, questions on my mind. Anyone in the meantime want to say anything can interrupt me. I mean, I just wanted to open this colloquium idea. The colloquium day, which will be also happening in tomorrow, it's very important, as you mentioned. It, triggers the encouragement of, the voice or outreach of the students, creates a kind of democratic platform somehow. And, breaks the asymmetrical relationship somehow that's going on throughout the education life. So maybe you can more elaborate on the colloquium. What's going on in colloquium day? What will happen tomorrow? Actually, you thought about this. But as I went through the jury members, for example, and the the jury members, I saw that there are many contributors. There are many jury members from Anatolian universities. That's, again, what I wanted to mention, as you also went through it. I mean, that's also very much opening a way in the interarchitectural education. I mean, sharing what they are doing together. Thank you for that. Yeah, it's just not a question, but because you have gone through on all of these things. But maybe I can just ask this. It's not very old tradition. You just experienced it two times, but does it also trigger the competition between the universities? Between the, as you said, Sezin Hocam, it makes everything transparent. I mean, everybody can see what you're doing somehow. Yeah. What do you think about that?
So, is it a question to me, Hocam, or to Ahmet Hoca, or to...
Together, to both of you,
So I think secretly it really triggers, it really triggers a kind of a competition in between the universities and the educators for sure. But I think everybody also believes in the greater good, it's maybe most it's the most important thing. To increase the educational quality. So besides triggering that, competition in between the competitive programs through students, through student works, students' works are actually the reflections of your approach in education, your performance. But I find it quite positive. I don't know what Ahmet would think, but that small, encouragement or trigger in the competitive world helps all of us, both students and the educators.
I agree. It triggers awareness and encourages dialogue. in my opinion, because you see, that is what I witnessed, at least, you see that personally I was also interested, that I say, oh, this approach, and I see the outcome, it, you know, encouraged me to see, to have a dialogue with the, you know, instructors of that project, to know about more, to know more about the process, how they could have this outcome. Because, you know, there are lots of different outcomes, various outcomes. Each one is, you know, maybe better in one aspect from the other. You know, there is no perfect outcome. I don't believe in that. But, you know, how you achieve this outcome, how do you achieve this outcome? It triggers a, you know, awareness and, you know, interest in them. In that sense, it is competitive. I believe it can be very healthy competition, let's say. And also, in our field, of course, you know, in interior design and architecture at the moment in Turkey is at an important turning point, let's say. You know, again, one after the other in the last couple of years, so many of the interior design department of interior design and architectures were established, and now you know, lots of different approaches for sure. And then at least for instance, in the juries I was in, one of the major questions we have was, you know, so simple but important question: what is an interior design project? For instance, this is a project of design. Obviously, the student here designs something, but is it architectural design? Is it interior design? How would you define it? These are very, very big questions. Of course, you cannot answer them within a colloquium or within a you know, a jury convening, but starting a dialogue about them, because these are very valid questions. They are very contemporary questions. Starting dialogues about them, I think, is a very, very good thing. And these are good platforms for. I mean, these competition juries are good platforms for that.
Yeah, and the chance to correspond what you're doing with the others, kind of confrontations. And there was a raising hand, Haydem Annasari, I think, right?
You there? Yeah. Good evening, Hocamlar. I have a question about this competition. I'm not sure if it's related with this meeting, but is there any competition coming soon, like, in this coming?
After the end of spring semester, there is going to be the new IM competition for 2021. So you will be able to participate with your first semester and second semester projects of 2020. So now we're in the fall semester. We're going to we're moving towards the spring. So both projects will be both projects are appropriate to participate with for the coming IM projects, IM competitions. It's most probably going to be announced around May or June. That's the time of announcements usually.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, are you from interior architectural department?
Yeah, I'm from interior architectural.
Yeah, okay.
And I would add, you don't need to confine yourself to the interior design competitions or awards. For instance, ceramic tile design annually organized. There are a couple of more I came across. You can find them if you search for them. One of them, Yurtbites, I think. And in lots of cases, the in the among the first three, there were students from the departments of interior design and architecture. So as an interior designer or interior architect, you can participate in lots of different, you know, competitions in lots of different branches of design. Your education enables it. You have the ability to look at design from many different scales. Great opportunity.
Yeah. Any other contribution? Enrijan, maybe another question can be again, as usual, about the pandemic situation. Do you think it affected? I mean, this competition, the participations to competition, does it have a negative or a positive effect on? Actually, the participations application started before the pandemic. Is it right?
No. It was the pandemic started on March 2020, mm-hmm. and the participations, submissions of the projects have started around August, finished at the very beginning of September. So yeah. All the process have been handled online. So we used to make it in the first one in MEF and in the second one in BAU. We had the first stage of the competition always online.
But
in the second one, we used to come together for a jury session. Yeah. And that's what we have liked about this process. However, mm-hmm. I think we made it on online platforms as well, because we had like 3 hours of discussion in the second year's session. So in the second stage. So again, we had that discussion on the last 12 projects. I mean, the most successful projects that have participated for the second year. So again, that discussion, we could have that discussion again, communication. But of course, coming face to face, seeing the being with the colleagues, mm-hmm. being with the students that we had the opportunity in MEF and BAU, mm-hmm. we couldn't have that opportunity to mm-hmm. create. Maybe it's most important thing is for the students to have that network. So it's kind of limited, but still it can
still continue. Goes on. Yeah,
yeah. It's going to continue. Hopefully, yeah.
So what about the exhibition, Hocam? Will it be live in tomorrow? On the Collegium Day, there happened to be some exhibitions of the awards.
As far as I know, they're going to again present the awarded 12, let me say, the most successful 12 projects. And of mm-hmm. course, the awards, they are going to be presented. Mm-hmm. Most probably, again, the exhibition will be online, but I'm not sure about it. We'll learn about all these information tomorrow.
Okay.
The colloquium.
Okay. Is there anyone who want to ask anything, any contribution? Or Mine Hocam, I think you have some words to say.
Thank you, Melahat Hocam. Thank you, Ahmet Hoca and Sezin Hoca, for this interesting presentation. It's been wonderful having you here. We have a little tradition here in ArchiDesign Talks. As Bahçeşehir University Faculty of Architecture and Design, we donate to TEMA in our guest's name. So Ahmet Hocam and Sezin Hocam, now you each have 5 young trees in a memorial forest in Eskişehir. Thank you both for creating the time to be with us today.
Can I have one tree at least?
I'll give you my tree. Don't worry, Melat Hocam. I'll share my tree with you.
Thank you. I'm sending messages from my background, in fact.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for this kindness.
Thank you, Mine Hocam.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Do you have any additional words? I mean, it was very, very nice, informatory for me to be with you. And I think for all the students and everyone here. Then we are waiting all our students, everybody, tomorrow to join to the colloquium together with us. Okay, yeah. We all be there. So that's an important ceremony, an important day, moment for at least interior architectural design students. Yeah. But everyone can join, I think.
Sure.
Right? Yeah. If there is no other words from anyone,
we can say good evening.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can say good evening. It's a bit hard for me to say good evening, but yeah.
Okay, then.